for me to reintroduce you to our special guests. A reintroduction there. They have been around all day. They continue to be around, and we're so glad. It's Kian, Shane, Mark, Nikki, and Brian, better known as Westlife. Have I said Kian right?
Yes, you have.
Yeah, Kian. Ian. But with a K.
Yeah.
I like that. Sorry, but it's very unusual. I like a little twist. Well, we're coming up to the millennium, and there's a lot of pressure on at this time of the year to have a Christmas single. But if you got to number one now, you'd go down in history.
Yeah.
Is the pressure on? Do you feel, you know, you've done very well already, but is the pressure on now for you to do better?
I think the pressure's definitely on to get a Christmas number one, because, like, obviously we've three number ones, and the bookies are kind of putting us favours and stuff like that, but we're just going to work as hard as we can.
Yeah.
And, like, it's the week, you can never tell with the chess, so we're just going to work as hard as we can and hopefully get it.
But you're working pretty hard already, aren't you? I mean, has that been a shock to you?
Well, no, the last year we've been very, very busy. You know, we've been all over the world, you know, promoting our three singles and our album. And it's just been great. We couldn't have asked for more, you know, because last year we were doing nothing. We were just finishing school and working regular jobs, and we're straight into this, and we're working. And, you know, we've had three number one singles and a platinum album. Can't ask for anything
more. Well, how do you keep your feet on the ground then? Because it's something of a dream. Does it feel real?
No. I think it's more, you know, our upbringing is being from Ireland. If you look at bands like Boys on the Chorus and Bewitched, they all seem like, you see them as stars, but when you meet them, you know, very, very normal people. Mm. So I think it's kind of in our blood, if you like, to sort of just remain the same. Yeah, because I think Irish people, you know, if they look at stars, when they meet them, if they are so-called, you know, shades and stars and all that, people don't like it. So I think when we go home, we try to be as normal as possible and just, you know, fit in with everybody.
Do you socialise together when you're sort of not at work, if you like?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, we're never not at work.
Well, yeah, you're not. Because, I mean, you know, the lack of time must be a killer.
True, yeah.
Yeah,
we're
working off a lot.
Yeah. But, that, I mean, I'm not detracting. I think that it's great what you've done, but there must be Christmas. Are you getting a little break?
Yeah, I think at Christmas time we have got some time off, but as far as, like, you know, being together outside the time of the band, we do, because we have a great friendship in the band. It's not just a working relationship. We have a great, you know, we're like a family, we're like brothers, we live with each other 24 hours a day. So we do have a kind of a, you know, a very strong bond there. So we do, whenever we get free time, we go out together, like, we go shopping, we go to the pub, we do whatever.
And you all understand each other, you understand your situation.
Yeah.
And that's
exactly.
Yeah.
That's important as well to for a winning formula, if you like, you know what I mean, to sort of understand each other and be able to live with each other and understand people's kind of bad habits and what people don't like, and, you know, and deal with it, you know what I mean. That makes.
But how bad happen. Can your habits be? Leaving trainers in the hotel room, that's
putting
sort of
your
thing.
Feet in the face.
Putting your feet into the space.
You get into the bus in the morning and Brian puts the feet up in the face.
So it's quite simple, really. It's not like it's hellish, it's just sort of normal family stuff.
Yeah, yeah, we're all on the same level, which is pretty good, you know.
Yeah.
We are kind of feel the same thing, so it's good.
Well, thank the Lord. What are you number one?
Well, if you buy the single, that will help.
Will it? Just me buying
and about all of you buying.
Everybody buys it. We have a very good chance.
Exactly.
We really don't know what it's like. I mean, we've got a double A side, so there's two songs to choose from. The Seasons in the Sun, which is a 70s hit,
mm-hmm.
and there's the ABBA song, I Have a Dream. So it's two cover. It's two songs, two cover versions. I mean, we're just going to try our best. We don't know. I mean, the bookies are, we're favourites in the bookies at the minute. So it's, we, you know, 5-4 favourites.
Well,
we don't
know
what to do.
2 weeks to go,
you know?
And with a double A side, you know, I think
class.
You're boxing clever there.
Should everybody knock Cliff off and we'll be all right.
In the nicest possible way, obviously.
Yeah.
Now, we've heard one side of the song before, Seasons in the Sun.
That's right, yeah.
So let's hear I Have a Dream. Where are
perfect
we?
Perfect Christmas present.
Taken from Abermania album, which is raising money for the National Foundation for Youth Music. Now,
sure.
Who's going to tell me a bit of that, about that?
Well, we got offered the chance to do it. It was for the Abermania special, and like loads of bands were doing, like Steps, Bewitched, and different bands, and we just thought, yeah, brilliant. And we didn't think it was going to be a single at the beginning. It was just for that show, and then like we liked it so much, and the reaction of that show was like amazing. So it just says Christmas single.
Carry
yeah.
on. Well, it's
great
a blinder, though, isn't it?
Well.
It's
great
a fabulous Christmas
under the tree, look perfect.
For your
album or
for
just the single?
Both. Because you see, the single on its own can be a bit skinny, so rapping can be hassle. So if you get,
get the CD, the video, and the book. See, the thing about it is, right, I Have a Dream isn't actually on the album, but Seasons in the Sun is. So if you buy the album and you get the single as well, you have an extra song.
Do you know what this is? It's genius, isn't it?
Yeah, it
is.
Right here on this.
Don't forget, you should get two singles in case one breaks. You've always got a spare one just to put in.
Yeah, right.
Now you're on the cassette as well.
Just in case one of the CD breaks.
That's a good idea.
There you go.
Now, if I've got one of those mini disc things, am I going to need it on mini disc?
You could need it on mini disc.
You could
buy the album on mini disc.
No, you can't. You can't do that. No, you just can't buy CDs. You don't record CDs.
Now, you've all got a very clean-cut image. Are we like... Well, I think you have, actually. You'll look nice. You know, my mum would be happy with you.
We just share it.
But, I mean, are you any plans to change your image? I'm thinking, like, I'm thinking Boyzone, and I'm thinking about
I don't think so. It's not really that we try to have a clean-cut image, if you know. We just kind of be ourselves and kind of dress to... as much as we can, the way we want to dress, if you know what I mean.
Do you have that say, or does somebody come and say, no, you will wear this?
Well, we do put a lot of trust in the record company and management and stuff, you know, because they know a lot more about the business than we do. So, you know, we kind of listen to them a lot when it comes to things like style. We have a stylist and we trust him as well, you know, so we listen to him and he tells us.
Is he here now?
he's not here at the moment. We'll see him later.
Is he really?
Yeah.
And now I'm sure that if you go to number one, you'll all be smiling.
This is
actually an appalling link.
Oh, yeah.
We've got a game now, which we're very cunningly calling...
When Irish Eyes Are Smiling.
Oh, it's good here, isn't it? Right, lads. As you know, the Irish are famous for two things, and only two things, I point out here. They are famous for being entertainers and smiling a lot, and only those things. I don't think they're famous for anything else. Just don't tell anyone in Ireland. I'm very sorry about that. So in this game, we want you to identify some very famous Irish entertainers by their smile. Right. This frightening-looking person. Is that not a bit menacing? Yeah. This to me, though.
Can we see his nose?
No, you can't. Now, here's the clue. He's a bit of a Danny boy.
Daniel O'Donnell.
Oh, it is.
Yes,
Daniel
O'Donnell.
Yes. Well played. Right, yes, number two.
Can I just interrupt you a moment?
What the heck?
Because you thought you were here for an interview on a terrible, terrible game. Do you know what? It's all been a sham on the false pretense, I'm afraid, lads. Because today, for Kieran, Nicky, Shane, Mark and Brian, this is your Westlife. Join us right after the break, please. Join us after the break.
You are in.